Hey guys, welcome to 1 Minute CM again. Good evening, Sunday evening. We have a nice cute couple here. This is the first couple show we are doing. So we have Sameer and Harsha joining in from Hyderabad. And a quick introduction about Sameer and Harsha. You know, they're basically founders of Thinker Learning. It's a platform where they're enabling leaders. They're enabling artists and they're enabling change. They're also at TEDx speakers, and they've done something really unique. They believe they've done one of the offerings which is really unique. That's called Anybody Can Paint. So they have influenced kids and people who cannot even see paint, and this has actually gone viral. So they have enabled around 7,000 people, for the last 5 years, which has made this particular difference. So we have a lot of people who really encourage Sameer and Harsha to do more of these. So thanks, Sameer and Harsha. So that's a quick introduction from my side. But aap log batao, how did you guys start, and why did you name this particular company Thinker? And what are your plans? Brought in so much of inspiration from people who given up, could not see. ये सभी कैसे आया आपके दिमाग में?
Sure, Harsha, you want to take it up?
Go ahead.
So Ravi, art has always been a passion, and in the formative years of setting up the career and building the career, it kind of took a back seat. In fact, there was no seat for art in our life, and it was just that in 2010-2011 is when the time I got some time to start re-engaging myself with art, and I got hooked onto it once again with art after my school days, and it was great fun, great enjoyment. And then it's a long story. After that, we kind of wanted to take it ahead and spread the joy of painting, because it was really, really therapeutic, enjoyable, and it turned the belief that I am not artistic, I am not creative, away from the lives of people. So we thought that that's a meaningful contribution to make. And when we started, Anybody Can Paint was the key offering, and hence we started getting recognized as Anybody Can Paint in the corporate world. But then, over a period of last 5 years, we started building more collaterals, more offerings, and we kind of became a holistic company where we had some creative offering in all the multiple intelligences, so to say. So hence we were looking for a different name which could encapsulate all the aspects of creativity that we were leveraging in our offerings. And hence we thought of the name Thinker. Thinker is all about, tweaking and being curious, tweaking with something, trying to open it up, being curious and learning hands-on. And it could be art, it could be robotics, it could be music, it could be anything. Hence, we thought that that particular word really reflects what we are trying to be. And that's how the name came into play.
That's really nice, Sameer, because honestly, one of the things in my bucket list is basically to get that stand where you can, put a canvas and paint something. That I've been thinking of it for a long time, but I've not done, taken that courage to do it. Because I know I want to paint something. I used to do that in my childhood, but uske baad nahi kiya. That fear that main nahi kar paunga is, holding me back. And what do I paint? लोग पसंद है, मेरे फोटोज पसंद करते हैं, बट पता नहीं मेरा पेंटिंग पसंद करेंगे कि लकीली फेसबुक डजंट हैव दैट डिसलाइक, बट पीपल विल हैव सैड फेसेस टू व्हाटएवर आई पेंट. सो या गुड 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 थिंग. सो व्हाट डू यू से हर्षा, फॉर व्हाट आर योर वर्ड्स ऑन इट? कैसे ये इनिशिएटिव आया कि एनीबॉडी कैन पेंट एंड दोस 7,000 हैप्पी सोल्स whom you could make them do this?
Yeah, sure. So I think Sameer beautifully encapsulated it in the way he described it. But just want to share that, both of us come from an learning development, leadership development, and human resource background. We both had, jobs, thriving jobs in the corporate. He was with Microsoft and I was with IBM. And we did that for a couple of years. In fact, more than a decade for each one of us. In fact, for him, it's more. He had a corporate career for about 16 odd years. And for me, it was about 11 years. And while we were in the corporate and we were engaged in various interventions related to organizational development, leadership development, learning and development, what we did realize was that, there will come an era where learning will need to be reinvented, where learning will need to become short, impactful, insightful, learning which can be delivered with a punch, learning which has more creative elements to it, more experiential elements to it. So we realized that, we are slowly getting into that era where, the generation we will tackle, in fact, everyone we tackle right now, the attention spans are reducing. So when Anybody Can Paint came alive, we thought that maybe this is kind of a start of our journey to reimagine learning. And then, initially our brand was called Anybody Can Paint, and then we reinvented and we realized that as we are expanding, our brand needs to be more cognizant to the variety of work we are doing with the corporates and the kind of work we want to do in the future. So it has to be more visionary in that perspective. And that's why Tinker got made as a brand, because we realized that we were using multiple intelligences to be able to curate and craft learning, which was fun, which was insightful, which is actually fun, insightful, and at the same time is able to deliver the message which, the companies and corporates are trying to target. So
Sorry to interrupt. Matlab, wife and husband, running the company, that's the awesome combination. I personally believe, but how is it going with you guys? Matlab, jhagadte nahi ho? Matlab, difference of opinion nahi aata kya dono ke beech mein?
So as they say, some amount of conflict is always good. That's what I will say. So yes, we do have our own differences of perspective. There are a lot of debates we have. What I'm happy to share is that from a principle perspective, from a value perspective, I think we both are completely aligned on what the organization represents, on what our vision is for the organization, on our morals and how we want to run the business, our business ethics. And I think when there is, when there is a character-centric approach, a more principle-centric approach, all of the minute differences and conflicts can always be discussed and amicably resolved. And I think that's what we do. But Sameer might have a different perspective. Let him also share.
No. Sameer sir, I won't ask. So we have some rapid-fire questions for both of you. Okay. So we are having the first time in this particular show. So a couple questions where you have to point out at each other. So I'll start asking questions slowly. So are you ready for it?
Oh, nice. This is interesting. You've sprung upon something to us.
Yeah. So this is being tried and tested on you first before we take it. Okay. So, before the rapid fire, these are some questions where you have to point out at each other. So who fell in love first between both of you? Yeah, I cannot see the thing. Sameer ka to, okay. So, pointing out at Sameer. Okay. Who is more annoying when they're angry? Okay. Who is the most spoiled?
Now, that's a difficult one. I don't think we both are spoiled. We continue to nudge each other for being way too practical.
I think she spoils me more than I spoil her.
Yeah. So, so you have to say this. Sameer, okay. You have to.
Sorry.
Who lies more? Who lies the most?
Lies. I think we are both fairly transparent and honest about everything with each other.
Yeah.
This is one example where both of you are lying on the screen together. Who takes care of the other ones, you know, they're drunk? Driving seat lunga ya lungi. Who's that?
Good question. Because between the both of us are very, very light drinkers, and this situation has never happened, unfortunately.
Okay, agar hoga to, who will take the responsibility?
But if it ever happens, I think he'll take care of me. I'm sure he'll take care of me. It I think it faintly happened once when, you know, interestingly, we had sent off both our children to our grandparents, their grandparents in Delhi. And we had gone out for a dancing night. And I remember that, I asked for cranberry and I ended up getting cranberry vodka. And that happened after I had already drank something else. So, you know, inadvertently, I ended up mixing drinks. And I was feeling a little dizzy. So while I was slightly in my senses, but still I was dizzy. So definitely he was the one who got me back. And then the next morning he explained to me that after that we had also had our dose of our favorite, meal, the Maggie, which I didn't remember. So I think, yes, he takes care of me.
Yeah, we also have
and that happens.
Coming in. Joel is complimenting that Samir makes awesome cocktails. So Samir, yeah, so I am coming in. when you both of you,
I think you're doing a good job in embarrassing him.
So when both of you are drunk, the neighbors are vouching for you. They're saying they'll take care of you. So that's from Sunita. And Sirisha basically says you guys are playing safe. You're not coming out with answers.
Okay.
Who has better hygiene?
Harsha has.
Definitely. I think we will strongly agree.
Yeah. Who makes more calls, or, you know, the call duration is very long?
He ends up having dinner 2 hours later than us because he's on a call with one of his long lost buddies and, you know, getting totally into that zone of memories. So yeah, long calls.
She makes more calls but shorter duration. I make very, very few calls but longer duration.
Longer duration. Okay. So text calls. Who's more on text? All the time typing.
Harsha.
Yeah. For the next couple rounds, we should also have this one. One can very eloquently point at themselves when that is very strong.
Yeah. Good that
very
I
strongly feel that we are the ones.
I was not getting response from Samir, so Harsha, that's the reason I pinged you first. So, who loves the other person more?
He loves me a lot. I know that.
Who's fun in the relationship?
I think I'm kind of more. I'm a bigger joker in amongst the two of us.
Okay. Yeah, his sense of humor is to die for.
Sab Sardar, sab Punjabi, you know, they come with this, this thing built in, inbuilt.
DNA mein.
DNA mein. Who spends
but generally also as a personality, he is very light-hearted and, I have learned a lot from him on not to take too many things to heart and, you know, just chill, relax. So, I have learned a lot from him on that aspect. Not to take tension. Tension lene ka nahi. Aur hum to dene mein bhi believe nahi karte. To na dene ka, na lene ka.
So, who spends more money?
Harsha.
I used to online shopping. Yeah. A lot of people who will watch this, maybe they are watching it live or they'll watch it later, will say yes. A lot of online shopping, especially my sister. Yeah. My sister is my go-to crime buddy on online shopping.
The Amazon guys must be missing you badly.
हाँ यार अभी तो अमेजोन से ही काम चलाना पड़ रहा है, बाकी सारी वेबसाइट्स खुली नहीं है ना, नहीं तो मिंत्रा भी होता है एंड जबोंग भी है एंड जिवामे भी है, बहुत वेबसाइट्स हैं,
कम नहीं है। Who's more talented now that you have equal profile? Who's more talented?
In what aspect? I mean, talent is a very broad definition.
Both are the founders of the company.
Has a very broad definition.
Yeah, who is the managing director and who is the CEO and who is the CMO?
I think I would say him because he is like, he is able to do a lot of things at one time in terms of, you know, I'm not just saying multitasking, but in terms of talent, I think from a perspective of creativity, of using multiple intelligences, which is our vision. The vision for Tinker is multiple intelligence. I think he's a more stronger contender for being able to play that part and for being able to, walk the talk. So, yeah, I would say so.
Who's the best kisser?
Oh, man.
Yeah.
No?
I think... Me.
Sameer, you have to start using your hand more.
Yeah, we can't see you. Yeah. Who's more stubborn?
Stubborn. Sometimes I think that could be again.
This question, you know, from the other room.
Yeah. See, if you can see, I have pointed all my hands towards him. Four of my hands are towards him. Four of my fingers are towards him.
Who dresses better?
Oh, of course, Harsha.
Okay. Who initiated the first kiss? Jab, you know, that love aajkal.
That was me, yeah.
Sameer?
Yeah. And that was, we went for a movie called Veer Zara.
Mm-hmm.
And post that movie, yes, we had that.
How did this happen?
Yeah, I might get a beating for sharing these spicy details online. But yeah, let me do that while I'm at it.
So, how did you do that? How did you accept his proposal, Harsha?
Actually, we were together. We did our MBA together in MDI, Gurgaon. And, our love story started in the campus. It was a very it is a very green and lush campus. And we have like lovely memories of that campus. And we used to, we were part of the same project group. And then we started going out for walks. We had this lovely connection over Maggie. We used to hate the hostel food and go out a lot for Maggie. And, a lot of things happened over there in terms of having conversations. A lot of comfort level is got established. And then, of course, we started going out for dinners and movies. And then, of course, the kiss happened. So it just flew in. He made me feel so comfortable. And the spark, the connection, everything. And it was, the spark and connection was not just, physical. It was more meaningful. It was at a deeper level. There was so much of a match in our thought process, in the way we were thinking, and our value system and everything, that it was very, very easy. Like it was a decision made in a jiffy. Of course, both of us come from different communities. I'm a Hindu, he's a Sikh, so I always had these reservations that my parents won't agree. In fact, my mom may be live right now and might be hearing this. And my dad too, that yes, it was, I had some reservations on how my parents will agree, but I always had this sense of confidence in him and myself that the strength of our relationship and our connect will help us to convince them. And in fact, if my father-in-law hears this later as a replay, because he's not on Facebook, he definitely deserves a big thanks, which we always offer to him offline as well, because he was the one who went to my parents, took that first step and just, made sure that he worked his magic on them and made sure that they agreed. So yes, it was easy. I don't think it was very difficult for us.
That's awesome. So who's the bigger baby when they get sick?
That's me.
I would agree. Yeah, he becomes very cranky and loses his patience a lot. He has a lot of patience. He, in general circumstances, in daily affairs, in daily routines, he definitely has into 20 times patience than me. Yeah, even with the kids, he has more patience. I tend to lose it. But when he is not well, or if there is a deadline, or something coming up which is getting him a little anxious, he gets really cranky. And it's not just us, but everyone around us, our children, people who work with us, our team, they all know that it's better to stay a little away from Sameer, because he's going to get like a little itchy very soon.
Good. Who apologizes first after a fight?
Harsha.
Yeah.
Yeah, confidence.
Sometimes the fight is initiated by him, and I still end up apologizing, and then I'm like, why did I apologize? What is wrong with me? But yeah, I always believe that you should never sleep over arguments. So it's just better to say sorry. Saying thank you and saying sorry is something which I think comes naturally to both of us.
Okay. So audience, if you have a contradictory answers to this, comment. Like Bhavna is saying that, Samir is the one. She doesn't believe that Harsha has a karmi sakti. But otherwise, who is more romantic?
I think it's me.
Yeah. So obvious first kisser. So
yeah, correct.
So who is the better cook?
Oh, of course, Harsha.
Ah,
nice. I love to cook. Cooking is therapy for me. In fact, I have a page called Joyful Food and Fitness Mantras, which is all about being able to share, hacks, recipes, tips, and fitness mantras. In fact, I don't know if you know and you realize, but I'm also a fitness coach with Sem Fitness. You had Sunita and Shilpi join in live with you, right? I'm part of their team.
You having a page, you are inspiring others about your cooking and stuff like that. Wo nahi malum tha, but yeah, I'll mention that here. I think, we'll start following that. That's new. So who takes longer time to get ready?
Harsha.
Nahi, aap. Even our elder one, sorry, I didn't get the last one.
Yeah, who's the grumpier in the morning?
No, we both aren't grumpy in the morning.
I think both.
Both?
I think both are okay. But maybe Harsha may be a shade more grumpier than me if we both end up being grumpy.
If I don't get my chai in the morning, I'm definitely grumpy. That's a big if.
So we have Anubhuti who's complimenting about your recipes, Harsha.
That's nice. Oh, nice. I'll have a look at those comments later. I don't think I can see them now, but yeah.
Okay, so now coming to the rapid fire question. So awesome performance. I think except for one answer, rest of the answers, everything was like perfectly right. So you know who's who. And each style. So, kitne saal ho gaye shaadi ho ke?
13.
13. Okay, nice. So it's great. 13 years mein pata chal gaya dono ka. Yeah, that's really the power couple. I think that should be the response. So awesome performance on the couple questions. So let's get on with rapid fire questions. If you could relive a year of yours, which age would that be?
For me, it would be 2006, 2005, 2006.
That's the first time you kissed her, right?
Yeah, correct. The first year, in the college that we were together.
I mean, you want to relive because you want to change the personality, or you want to re-experience that?
Re-experience that.
Okay,
you know, that's nice. Fully funded, you know, nice campus to live in, full freedom. What else one would want for?
I agree. You know, some colleges just have awesome campus. We, you know, matlab movie shoot wahi pe ho jata hai.
वहीं पे मूवी शूट हो जाता है एग्जैक्टली.
व्हाट वाज योर फेवरेट डेट?
हूम आर यू आस्किंग दिस वन? बोथ ऑफ अस?
या बोथ ऑफ यू. यू कैन गो विद ऑप्शंस
आल्सो. आई थिंक वी हैव वी हैड न्यूमरस डेट्स, बट यू नो टू ऑफ देम व्हिच I distinctly remember is, of course, the first one is the Veer Zara date, where, you know, everything popped and changed. And of course, you know, on our 10th anniversary, we went to Goa and, you know, we did a you know little celebration with our family at the beach. So there was a moment at the beach where we were together and everyone else was slightly away. And, you know, there was a different kind of a connect. So those are two which I distinctly remember. But all dates with him are always special and amazing and fuzzy.
Cool. Do you think that today's generation, youth, in terms of, you know, romance?
I didn't get the last one.
Ravi, your voice broke.
Okay. Yeah. Do you think that today's generation of youth have it tougher than what you did, or do you think that it's much easier to fall in love?
Tough question. Don't know much youngsters these days, but I think it must be a little more easier, at least in the urban cities, obviously, because the generation of parents these days are even more flexible and open to their children's choices and wishes. And of course, with the technology and with the kind of exposure, you know, folks have much more exposure these days. So I would think that it is more easier now.
What do you say?
I think I have a double-edged answer to this. I think it's both easy and tough in a way, because I believe that it's easier since there are many more, everything is online now. People are more social and, you know, people are finding each other more socially. There is this Tinder and, you know, whatnot available, dating apps available. Hamare time pe to shaadi.com bhi itna active nahi tha. Uske ek do saal baad hi hua tha. But yeah, in terms of choices, all the youngsters have a lot of choice, so that way it's easier. But when you have too much choice and you have too much power, it sometimes becomes tougher to exercise the right choice. So one quote which is coming to my mind is that with huge power comes huge responsibility also. So there is, I think, with youngsters there is even more a perspective to being able to leverage these choices more mindfully and responsibly.
Yeah, I also agree with that, because I also feel that with this technology it's easier to express, but maintaining that relationship after that is much more tougher now compared to earlier days. Okay, have you guys ever pretended to sleep to avoid an argument?
Man, you're very creative in the questions. I have done that. I have for sure done that.
In the past, yes. I think in early years of our relationship, it used to be like you know, we would have an argument. And, you know, in early years of any relationship, till the time you understand the person well and understand the perspective the person is coming from, you know, some expectations the other individual has from you, there are bound to be some arguments, even in a love marriage. So we had our share of, as well. And at those times, you know, Sameer had this propensity to, you know, retract away. But I think over the period of years, with a lot of constant nudge and feedback to each other, I can very honestly admit that our communication channels are very, very open now. And I don't see him doing that, or I don't see myself running away from an argument. I think we do tackle it head on. It doesn't mean that tackling each other head on, but tackling the argument and, you know, having a proper conversation around it, being able to dig deep and ask the right questions and resolve the matter.
Cool. So that's like a truth and dare question. That's what Sarika says.
Sorry?
Sarika is complimenting that the question which I asked is more like truth and dare. Actually, a truth and dare bhi dekha tha maine. There are a lot of questions I cannot ask when anybody is on live. So yeah, I said, okay, this app is not working out.
Thank you, God.
It seems like we made you prep a lot, Ravi.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, next question. If you had to get rid of one thing that belongs to you, you know, your wife or, you know, hubby, what would it be? One thing that you have to get rid of, Harsha. One thing that you have to get rid of that belongs to Sameer.
One thing which I... Okay.
Yeah. Which, you know, belongs to each one of you. So, which the other person wants to get rid of. It can be a physical thing. It can be a mentality. A behavior aspect. But what training do you give leadership? Now tell me. 13 years,
what
one thing you want to get rid of?
Harsha has worked a lot on her anger, and I would just pick that as I would just pick that again, and going forward, one thing, basically selecting response over reaction. Sometimes it has come to a point that it is very minimal, but since I have to pick one, I would pick that.
Okay, so what about you, Harsha?
It's not a short answer. I think when he needs to focus on something, there is a lot going on in his brain, which focuses on that particular aspect, but he does not communicate it. So there are times when, you know, our arguments or our irritation, or my irritation rather towards him, would be around the fact that I don't see him focusing on that aspect. It seems like we've agreed that aspect is important, but I don't see him focusing on it. So there's a lot going on in his brain, and later I get to know that there was a lot going on in the brain, but it did not get communicated to me, and hence there was, you know, this irk from my side. So one thing which I would like him to do more is, you know, sometimes just communicate a little more when he thinks that I am getting anxious about something, and he already has a plan for it, or he already has thought about it. So yeah.
I think I can start this particular question and, you know, counsel and, you know, get a lot of people, you know, settled down with their issues. Yeah, this question is really good. I'm using it.
But this is not a new issue. We are talking about it online live, but both of these issues we have spoken to each other. So now our friends and family know it. I think that's the difference.
Good. We have a question from Dr. Mrinalini. Who makes bed coffee?
Okay, so Harsha makes it. I do it very, very rarely. And we basically like tea. We both used to have tea in the morning, but I've switched to hot water and honey, and she continues with tea. So, I make my hot water and honey, she makes her tea.
Yeah, but in the evening, we still enjoy our cup together. because he still gives in to having chai in the evening with me, because I've, you know, I nudge him to for that cheers, for that company. So yeah, he makes nice chai.
Evening, mostly 80% times she makes, 20% times I do.
Good. So talking in these lines, I have a question. This was not in the list, but you know, a question. Samir, you have to be really honest. What is that one dish which, you know, Harsha makes it with passion, you know, offers it for you, you know, which is very healthy, and you know, one of the dishes she prepared for the photograph which she wanted to post on her page, but doesn't really taste good, but you have to like really give compliments saying that it's bahut acha hai, healthy.
Yeah, I like that question.
At least
some of them,
you've gone through multiple you know, dishes like this, but what is that one thing which you can remember?
I am very transparent with her. I give her the inputs on whatever she cooks. But yeah, I mean, cakes. I have a very, very, very sweet tooth. So I love very, very sweet, sweet cake. If it has to be cake, it has to have the, you know, the icing. It has to have the white sugar in it and all that. But she prefers the healthy side. So she's very creative in making whole wheat cakes. And instead of using white sugar, use different material, like some fruit extracts or something. So those taste good. But of course, you know, being a sweet tooth guy, I would definitely inch for the traditional cakes.
Okay, point heard. Traditional cake coming up soon.
Dr. Nunalni again, who packs the luggage when you plan travel?
Harsha.
That's nice. Okay, so one word that describes Samir. Harsha, the question is for you.
Tough one. I have multiple words and they are all different. They are not synonyms of each other. Can I use more?
One word. It has to be one word.
Okay. Passionate.
Okay. Yeah. Samir, one word that describes Harsha.
Affectionate.
Affectionate. Okay. Good. So that completes the rapid fire questions. But dear friends, you have any questions for the lovely couples here, feel free to ask. Your compliments are really good. Thanks for pouring in the compliments. And I have an image which I wanted to share and, you know, ask you questions. These are something which I pulled from your account. So, yeah, this one I really need help. I mean, this is an image of all the photographs, a collage of, you know, multiple people, you know, representing something in the painting. So can you talk something about this?
Yeah, this image I believe is the collage of a lot of people who have participated in various sessions, you know, under Anybody Can Paint. And I believe this is a good representation of what, you know, different people have been able to achieve. And the most interesting part is that most of these people, you know, when they got into the session, they believed that they cannot paint, they cannot draw, and they didn't even recall the last time they had ever held a brush in their hands. And the outcome is something which is really heartwarming to see, and hence this image is very priceless for us.
That's nice.
Yeah.
So I also see some media coverage by The Hindu, Times of India and Indian Express. So, you know, how was the feeling, you know, after the achievement and, you know, you're getting recognition and, you know, feedback, you know, is this more important or the feelings what you received, you know, live while you were there when these guys were painting after the event?
Harsha, go for it.
Okay. Yeah, sure. So I think, Ravi, for us, you know, the media coverage was more like we considered it more like a vehicle for being able to spread our vision and our word, because we believe that everyone can draw and paint. And a lot of us have this limiting belief that we are not creative. And, you know, most of the times when we go for workshops for corporates, for publics, for schools, institutions, and when we ask people to raise their hand on how many people believe that they cannot draw or paint, and it could be anywhere between, you know, a 15, 20 year old person to a 70, 80 year old person, more than 90% of the hands go up to say that I cannot draw and paint, or the last I drew or paint was in school time and I was not good at it. So we believe that there is an artist in everyone, and it is just about getting the right motivation, the right guidance, and for being able to overcome that limiting belief, having that empowering belief, that positive mindset. So I think all of these media coverages of the work we've done have kind of spread the word, spread the joy of painting, have helped people realize that if this can happen to 7,000 odd people who came into our sessions believing that they cannot draw or paint, and they went back with their own masterpieces, which they hung back proudly on one of their walls, then it can happen to anyone. And, you know, this is just a metaphor to so many other limiting beliefs, which we all have, including us. Both of us, we keep talking to each other about the limiting beliefs we have in ourselves. And how is it that we can, you know, look at empowering people, empowering ourselves, and, you know, checking and kind of questioning and nudging. So I think that feeling of being able to reach more people and that urge to be able to spread the joy of painting, to spread the joy of creation to everyone is what keeps us going.
Cool. Good, good. I think that's a very good representation of, you know, the efforts versus recognition. Once you get recognition, I think that has to go viral. So good point on that, Harsha. So
now, one additional comment on this, Ravi, was that you know, when we were in the thick of this this entire work, we kind of realized that this the art of painting is categorized under the visual arts category. So we somehow felt uncomfortable with the fact that why any form of art should be categorized as visual. And that gave us a notion as to, you know, why shouldn't this art be democratized and open source to people who have any, any visual challenges. So we had an idea, and then we thought that, okay, let's experiment it out. And we had two people from the LV Prasad, you know, rehabilitation center who had vision loss. And we experimented with them. We sat with them on over a weekend. We thought it would take maybe 2 or 3 days to understand them and help them with an art project, with a painting project. But we were very optimistic. We thought in 2 or 3 days, we will be able to, you know, collectively come up with a process where people with vision loss can also paint. But to our surprise, in a matter of few minutes, they were able to paint with pretty awesome paintings as we were guiding and coaching them. So that was like a big learning for us, that, you know, people with vision loss, you know, have come to believe that, you know, painting is not for them. And though, you know, with some encouragement and support, they are able to follow the instructions so well, and they have such a strong perception of material and touch and feel that, you know, they can create anything. So that's what, you know, encouraged us to try with, you know, multiple projects with them. And we were blessed to have gotten the opportunity to partner with many NGOs like that and do sessions with 30, 40, 50 people. And even do sometimes session wherein people with vision as well as people with vision loss were part of the same cohort, and they were painting. And you can actually see that there was no difference between the outcome of both the category of people. So, you know, that was our endeavor to kind of, you know, get this art form free of this word visual. And that's what, you know, kind of got, you know, interest generated in a lot of circles and people wanted to know more about it. And we got invited. In fact, one of the participants, Aishwarya, you know, she kind of got initiated into art so much that she is she's a visual artist now, so-called visual artist now, and she lost her eyesight completely when she was 18 years old. So she's churning out great paintings now, and her art is also going into various exhibitions. So yeah, that's the power of art that keeps us really excited, motivated, and this is the number one lesson that we learn in our life, to hold the crayon and make a simple drawing and coloring. But what happens is the second lesson of our life, which is counting numbers, becomes so important in our life that we end up believing that we can only count numbers well, but we cannot draw a figure properly. So that's our whole endeavor, to bring back this creativity into the lives of people, and without any boundaries or so-called limitations.
That's really awesome. That's great. So we also have a question from Dr. Munali, which will be challenged to find. Do you also look into especially children, you know, differently abled children on this particular project? So are you still continuing this? Are you still on a mission? Are you adding more people apart from this 7K plus?
Yes, yes, we are on the path of continuing on this, and our hope is to continue to spread the joy of painting and make people really believe that they can create wonderful paintings. And all this while, we were engulfed in this physical area in India, in all these cities. We were conducting sessions in and out of various cities. But now, because of the power of technology, we have got a very big lever. So we are now, we have started coming up with our e-learning programs, with which we can reach out to far and wide. We can reach out to more people across the world and take basically open source art and spread it to everyone. Because a lot of art techniques and concepts remain kind of closed door, and they are kind of secret somewhere hidden in the artist community. We want to open source it so that everyone can engage in it. So e-learning programs is the next thing which we are focusing on heavily.
Super. So the final question, 1 minute CM. So if both of you together become the chief minister, would you deny that offer? Matlab, loge saath mein karoge ya bologe ki one of you would be nominated to take the charge, the second one will take care of home? So what would you do? And if you guys become the one chief minister, what would you focus on?
Harsha ko bana do, main ghar sambhal lunga.
Nahi, mujhe I would say ki I would love to be the CM along with him. I cannot actually imagine my life without him. And it has been such a wonderful, I mean, wonderful is, I think, a very short and a small word to describe my feeling of, co-hosting Tinker, co-running Tinker as a company with him. And not just professionally, but personally too, the journey with him is the journey I would choose in every life, without getting too emotional about it. So yeah, would love to be the CM along with him and, do something which lies close to our heart in terms of bringing in more awareness about multiple intelligences. I know there are some schools and some educational institutes which are already focused a lot on multiple intelligences, but increasing the awareness about multiple intelligence, enabling and supporting more institutes and more vehicles to be able to leverage creative learning in its own ways, because there is a lot of power which lies in being able to leverage creative learning and multiple intelligences to support all kinds of learning. So I think would love to get into that area more and build in more focus there.
Super. So we also have compliments saying that you guys will make the state colorful. You guys become the chief minister.
Oh yeah, definitely. Color is vibrant, and color is what adds the pop in our lives and in so many lives around, I think. So would love to add the color. Thank you for that compliment, whoever said that.
That's Dr. Munali. So great, guys. Thanks for joining in. Keep spreading the positivity which you guys are doing. Keep spreading colors. get that artist out of everybody. You know, I'm sure these leadership classes and the workshops are really tough. I understand though this is a critical part of any organization, and this has generally taken a back step. You know, companies do not take priority to train their leaders, and you know, we still have leaders who keep making mistakes because they're not trained, they're not put in line with what they should really learn. So awesome job, you know, parallelly whatever you're doing to inspire others. You have a wonderful team, you have wonderful friends who've been joining and complimenting you guys. So we also have some questions which you might have to answer online and offline, who's the best couple in the world, and how do you guys want to become one. So some of these things do take offline, and thanks for joining in. Thanks for taking time off. I mean, this is the first couple session, and I found it really interesting. And mere ko bhi confidence aa gaya ki aise cheeze kar sakte hain. And I have one question which I can always ask in any couple life question session. So thanks guys, thanks Samir and Harsha, and very cute.
Thank you, Ravi. I think a lot of compliments to you in being able to host this platform. Especially in the current context, I think it's very important to be able to share perspectives live. So thank you for being able to leverage this platform, and thank you for the invite. I think we really enjoyed being here and kind of reliving some of our old memories. Some of your questions triggered that, and that brought us into a happy and nice place. So thank you for that.
Yeah, so time for replay of Veer Zara once this live session is done.
Thank you so much, Ravi. You are really good at putting all these questions together. I'm sure you'll make future couples comfortable and uncomfortable at the same time for all the good reasons. So, and hope to see you someday once the normal life is back. I don't know when, yeah. Hope to paint with you someday.
Yeah, I definitely want to be part of one of the events, whether it is NGO or corporate events where your people are, drawing colors. I definitely want to be part of it. I want to see it live. So, do invite me whenever you guys are doing this.
I mean, 100%.
Even if it's
absolutely
NGO,
yeah.
We'll try to do our best to spread.
Certainly.
Thank you, guys. Enjoy the Sunday evening, and thanks for joining.
You too. Bye-bye. Thank you, everyone who joined in and logged in.
Thank you, everyone who came in live with us, and whoever will be listening to the replay. Have a great evening.
Have a great evening.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.